Gmail provides several different types of inbox. These inbox types let you view your messages in different orders, and you can play around with them and see which one you like best, depending on the way you like to manage your emails during the course of the day. So, all of the inbox types are available by clicking on the down arrow next to inbox right here on the Gmail interface. And you'll notice that there are five different types. Default is default, and that puts the newest message at the top, regardless of whether it's read or not. The newest message is at the top, and the oldest message is at the bottom. Another type is important first. Now, what this does is Gmail tries to learn what messages are important based on a few different criteria. Based on how often you interact with the sender, based on keywords in the subject or in the body. Now, you can teach Gmail if something's important or not by clicking on this little yellow chevron next to the message. So, if something is important, go ahead and mark it as important. If it's not, you can click the chevron and Gmail will say, okay, it's not important. Over time, it will learn your habits and it'll learn your patterns. And I've heard from some folks that it can be very, very accurate. Unread first is the one that I tend to use the most. And this puts all of your unread messages at the top. So the newest unread is at the top and the oldest unread is at the bottom. Everything else that's read is down here past this divider. And this also is in newest at the top, oldest at the bottom. So you could have a message that's actually newer down here, but since you read it, it'll put it down here. This is good for making sure that you read everything and you are assigning priority to your messages correctly. I tend to use this the most just to make sure nothing sneaks up on me during the day. Another option is starred first. Now, starred is kind of like important, but instead of the Google algorithm assigning importance, you do it manually. So, the way you add a star is by clicking on the star icon next to a message. So, you just manually click the ones that are important to you. And then, if you wait a little while, or if you go ahead and refresh your inbox, it will move those into starred. So, all the starred messages are here, and everything else is below. And again, the default is for the newest starred message to be on the top and the oldest starred message to be on the bottom. Now, if you notice, there's when I click the star, it shows me one color. But if you go into your settings and you go about halfway down, you'll notice that there's many different types of stars. So in use is just the yellow one. But if you want, you can drag and drop the actual stars you'd like to use, or you can use one of these presets, four stars or all the stars, to get the exact color combination or icons that you'd like. So in this case, let's say I want to use two different star colors and then a question mark and a check. So once you get the stars aligned, no pun intended, exactly how you want, go ahead and scroll down and hit Save Changes. Now, when you click, every time you click, it'll give you one of the different star options. So I can make this one a question mark. And again, if I wait long enough or if I hit refresh, that new the starred one will go into my starred section. So another view is priority inbox. This is kind of cool because it's a combination of important, unread, and starred. So anything that's unread and the Google algorithm has marked as important will be here in the top section. The middle section are things that are starred, so you manually mark these as important. And then everything else is down here at the bottom. Newest at the top, oldest at the bottom, read and unread are intermixed down here in this section. So again, important and unread at the top, ones that you manually designated as important in the middle, and then everything else in chronological order at the bottom. So play around with which view you like best. Everyone has their preference. I have another video that talks about how to use these settings along with some labs to make it look like Outlook or Lotus Notes if you're migrating from one of those two platforms. But I invite you to play around and pick what works best for you. If you like these videos, please hit subscribe. Thank you.